Hello everyone, now we have to discuss another type of theorem, that is compensation theorem. So why it is named as compensation theorem? For example, if you consider Thevenin's equivalent circuit, in that circuit what we have? Thevenin's voltage in series with RTH, finally we have load resistance, right? For example, if there any changes in the load resistance, means the load resistance it changes from some value to another value, obviously the current in the circuit also changes, right? So in order to compensate the changes in the circuit, we have to introduce some voltage. That voltage is nothing but compensating voltage. And finally, we have to calculate the change in current. That's it. That is the motto of this theorem. See, the statement is, in a linear time invariant network, when the resistance of a load branch carrying a current is changed by delta R, changes to delta R, then the currents in all branches would change, and those values can be obtained by assuming that an ideal voltage source of Vc has been connected such that the value of Vc is nothing but I into delta R in series with R plus delta R, when all other sources in the network are replaced by their internal resistances. Why other sources are replaced with internal resistances? We have introduced here what? Ideal voltage source. For ideal voltage source, we do not have any internal resistances, right? So, this is the statement. Just wait for some time, I will explain this statement with respect to different circuit diagrams, ok. First, we have to draw Thevenin's equivalent circuit. So, this is plus minus. This is VTH, this is RTH, and this is RL, right? The current through this branch is nothing but I, right? So from this, what is the value of current I? I is equals to Thevenin's voltage by total resistance, clear? So this is the circuit you have considered. Then the value of the resistance changes to some value, that is changes to delta R, then the circuit becomes this is VTH, this is RTH, see this is RL plus delta RL. The value it changes from RL to delta RL, then the value of current is nothing but, for example, I dash, right? All values should be changes, therefore I dash is equals to VTH by RTH RL plus delta RL, clear? Then in order to compensate these changes, we have to introduce a compensating voltage, that is Vc. Then the circuit becomes what? This is Vc, this is what? RL plus delta RL. This current is called as change in current, delta I, this is RTH. Simple, from these two, where delta I is nothing but this total current from the circuit 1, I minus I dash, I minus I dash. So, after solving these two equations, we will get delta I is equals to change in current is equals to minus Vc by RTH plus RL plus delta RL. We got this value, which is nothing but Vc is nothing but what? I into delta R minus I into delta R by RTH plus RL plus delta. So, this is the value of compensating voltage and the change in current. Finally, we have to calculate the change in current. This is nothing but compensation theorem. Next, we will discuss one example for this compensation theorem. So, from this circuit, calculate the change in current through R3 when it is incremented by 3 ohms. So, there is a change in R3, we have to calculate the incremented current delta I. So, change in resistance, what is the value of change in resistance? That is delta R, which is equals to what? 3 incremented by 3 minus given is 2. So, delta R should be equals to what? 1 ohm, right? So, delta R is equals to 1, clear. Then we have to calculate Thevenin's equivalent circuit first, later we have to calculate change in current plus minus. Right, this is 6 2 2, so we have to calculate VTH plus minus. So from this plus, from this VTH is equals to 3, right? So we have VTH. Next RTH, we have to calculate. This is VTH. This is 2 ohms. 2 between these 2, we have RTH. Therefore, RTH is nothing but what? 1 ohm, right? Those 2 are connected in parallel. Next, we have to calculate I, right? I is nothing but what? VTH by RTH plus R, which is equals to, what is the value of VTH? 3 by RTH is what? 1, given R value is what? 2, which is nothing but 1 ampere, clear. Then we have to get from this VC is equals to what? Before drawing the circuit diagram, I into delta R, right? What is the value of I? 1 into delta R is nothing but 1. So, 1 volt completed. Next, we have to get the equivalent circuit by replacing this independent sources. Short circuited, plus minus, right? So, this is RTH. What is the value of RTH? 1 ohm. This is R plus delta R. What is the value of R? Which is equals to 2 plus 1, 3, right? This is VC, which is equals to 1 volt. From this, we have to calculate delta I. That's it. Therefore, delta I is nothing but R VTH, that is VC only, 1 by 1 plus 3, right? 1 by 1 plus 3. So, delta I is nothing but 0.25 amperes. Delta I is nothing but 0.25 amperes. That's it. VC is nothing but compensating voltage. From this, we have the 0.25 amperes of change in current.